Home for most of you was slushy, but the snow is making its mark now tonight. A lot of streets are snow covered, and Eric Flack is live with our number two story. Eric?
Hey, Sheree. You know, the snow and the slush is starting to build up a little bit out here on the streets of Cincinnati. Now, road crews were planning on switching from salt trucks to plows as soon as they got enough accumulation out here on the road. The problem with that is that the plows take a lot longer than the salt trucks, and that's going to delay the whole process of clearing the streets. Meanwhile, anybody who was out on the streets was doing their best not to let the snow slow them down. Getting around, no easy task. As a wintry mix covered streets and sidewalks around Cincinnati.
Already getting pretty slick?
Yep, it is. It's real bad.
Some just stayed inside and avoided the mess altogether. Kevin and Joy Rosebrook were one of the few eating out in Hyde Park.
Yeah, and our steak was perfect, and we said it was probably because it was the only steak he was cooking.
It was
back
great
there.
And for the brave that did venture out,
a big bag of salt in there.
Things were slow going, to say the least. Trying to get out while they still can, in case things are even worse tomorrow.
There's a long way to the top, isn't there?
Yeah.
Now, the big question overnight is how much of this stuff on the streets and roads is going to freeze. You do need to keep in mind that the road crews are going to focus on the main drags first, which means a lot of these side streets could be snow-covered and slick until well into tomorrow. Reporting live from Mount Auburn, I'm Eric Flack, News 5.
By dawn, in the northern suburbs, you could be shoveling close to half a foot of snow or more. Let's see how much of that is already greasing the skids on roads in Butler and Warren counties. Curtis Fuller, live with the number three story. Curtis?
Well, you know, Jack, we're up here in Mason, and you're going to show you King's Mill right now. You don't see a lot of traffic, and actually, that is a good sign, and here's the reason why. It appears drivers have been listening to what we've been saying. They've stayed off the roads. Many people said, look, we're just going to pack it in early tonight. That's the best thing. We have seen many trucks out and about here in Warren County, as a matter of fact. We stopped by the ODOT location. 21 trucks out, we're told, and they said things have been running pretty smoothly here in Warren County. Over in Butler County, we also checked over there, right around the Tylersville exit, and we were over there right about the time when the sheriff of Butler County declared a level one emergency advisory, I should point out. And that means that the situation, people out and about should use caution. There have been several reports of some accidents over in Butler County, and we've been keeping an eye on that. But again, the good news tonight, people have been listening. They heeded the warnings. Reporting live, I'm Curtis Fuller, News 5. Boy.